Welcome viewers, if still you're not subscribed to this channel, kindly subscribe and also click the bell icon to get technology updates regularly on this JP Infotech channel.
Hi everyone, in this video we are going to see about a Python project which is entitled as Customer Churn Prediction Using Deep Learning Technique. So basically, churn means that it is a measure where it will be finding whether a customer will continue with the service provider or they will leave with the service provider. So basically, here we are going to take a data set of a bank, so a banking data set. So we'll be finding whether those banking data set customer will continue with that bank or not. So here you can see the system architecture where the bank customer data set is given as the input and pre-processing and feature selection is made, and then it is been given to the classifier ANN and the prediction result is shown, and then the performance analysis and graph part will be shown. This is the system architecture and flow of the project. And here you can see the data set that we are giving: customer churn data set and pre-processing, model selection, feature selection, and the classification using a artificial neural network, and the prediction accuracy, precision, and these values. And then we'll be seeing the performance analysis and the graph. Now let us see the execution of the project. Before that, I'll show you the data set part. So this is the churn modeling data set which is being referred from the Kaggle. So here you can see the features like row number, customer ID. So basically all the bank the customer ID. So this is the customer ID, and the surname, the name of the customer, the credit score. So generally if the customer is having higher credit score, they'll not leave the bank. So like that, here they are given about the credit score and geography, the location of the customer, and the gender of the customer, and the age of the customer. So basically these details will be collected from the bank. And the tenure means that how many years this customer is with this bank. Basically the longer tenure period customers will not leave the bank. And balance, so higher balance people will not leave the bank. And this is number of products. So this is the number of product, is like through this bank this customer, how many products they have purchased through this bank. And this feature is has credit card, whether this customer has had a credit card with this bank or not. And this feature is active member, so whether this member is active with the bank or not. And this feature is estimated salary, and with this feature, with the higher salary people most probably did not leave the bank. And this feature is like exited, so whether the customer is available or not. So now let us see the execution of the project. So copy the source code location, go to the command prompt. And before seeing the execution of the project, you need to have these libraries installed. Now copy the source code location, go to the source code location, type python app.py and click enter. After a few minutes you can see this epoch will be running. This 150 epoch is being completed. You can see this URL. Just copy this URL, go to any of the browser. I'm going to Firefox and just paste this URL. Now you can see the home screen or welcome screen of the project with the project title, customer churn prediction using artificial neural network. So now here you can see the login menu. Just click this login menu. So this is a static login page because we are not using any database here. So just enter the default username and password as admin and admin, and then click login. And once the login is successful, it will be navigated to the upload part where you need to upload the data set. So just select this browse folder, go to the project folder where you can see upload.csv file. Select this file and then click upload. After few seconds, the page will be navigated to the preview part where you can see the data set that I have explained about, so which consists of ID, customer ID, surname, credit code, geography, gender, age, tenor, balance, number of products, has credit card, is active member, estimated salary, exited. So just you can scroll down till the end of the page, so you can see the complete data set has been loaded into the browser part. So here you can see the data set consists around 10,000 data set records, and then you can see the button click to train or test. Just click it. After few seconds, you can see the message training is finished. Click OK. After that, it will be navigated to the prediction part where you can see the customer churn prediction. So here you can enter the test data and predict the results of it. So now let me enter a few details. So let me enter the credit score for this as 376, country as Germany, gender as female, age 29, tenor 4 years, balance 115,046, number of products 4, has credit card yes, active member no, estimated salary is 119,346. Let me click this predict button. So now you can see the customer will leave the bank. This is the prediction result for the data set that I have entered. Now let me show you the other case. So the credit score is 476, country is France, gender female, age 34, tenor 10, balance 0, number of products 2, has credit card yes, active member no, estimated salary is 26,260. Let me click predict. Now you can see the customer won't leave the bank. So I have shown you both the positive and negative case. Now let me show you with other case also, few more examples. So credit score is 655, country is Germany, gender is male, age is 41, tenor is 8, balance is 125,561, number of product is 1, has a credit card no, active member no, estimated salary is 164,040. Let me click the predict button. Now the prediction result is the customer won't leave the bank. Let me check with the final case. Credit code is 585, country is Germany, male, age is 36, tenor is 5, balance is 146,050, number of product is 2, has credit card no, active member no, Estimated salary is 86,424. Let me click the predict button. So here you can see the customer won't leave the bank. So for the few scenarios I have shown with the different cases of for data set records, you can also check with the other data set records from the data set that we have trained up with. So now let me move to the performance analysis part. So just click this performance analysis. So here you can see the precision and recall value, where the precision and recall value and also the confusion matrix. And finally comes the chart part. This is a static chart because we have not used data set as I intimated earlier. So this data set has been, this chart has been depicted from the data set that we are trained up with. So this consists of customer churn about 40% and normal customer around 60%. So customer who can live is around 40%, customer who can retain is about 60%. And this is all about the project customer churn prediction using deep learning or artificial neural network. And thank you for watching.